hey, listen, in this business, you got to be a little bit crazy, or in my case, a lot of bit crazy, but I'm going to talk about how to get in the right mindset for open enrollment, a 45-day absolute all-out sprint.
Look, insurance sucks. I just make it suck less.
Hey, welcome back for another video on open enrollment and getting prepared. Listen, the right mindset is going to take you far. And if you're like me, I believe that mindset is actually everything, right? It actually is the foundation that everything else is built on. And so I want to talk to you about building the right foundation mentally for going into open enrollment, a successful open enrollment. Before I do, as a reminder, we created this channel for agents just like yourself. So if you know other agents that are maybe needing a message like this, or maybe needing some additional motivation going into open enrollment, share this with them. You know, throw a like, throw a comment so that we game the algorithm and they see this video. We're getting a ton of traction on the channel. This is the time of year where I believe agents need to hear it most. So help us get the word out there. We so appreciate it. We created this channel for agents like you to help you polish your skills, make more sales, and ultimately make more money out there helping people. So thank you so much for dropping in. Love to hear from you. Matter of fact, quick little side note. I'm the king of side notes, but quick little side note. I've kind of taken a big step back on the content, and we're filming everything in 1 hour, 2 hour blocks, and we're running 4 weeks of content. That's why you see me in the same shirt over and over again in these videos, just in getting ready for open enrollment. So I'm actually practicing what I'm preaching here today, but there's some other reasons as well. But you know, I want you to know that this has been a very humbling experience, because as I pull back, as I'm doing less on the channel, it's still getting just as much traction. And that's the true value of content. You know, it lives here on the internet forever, and it's continuing to get more and more and more traction. So thank you so much for all of you guys who have commented and reached out lately. I absolutely love it. That's why I do this. You know, it actually gets a little bit lonely when people don't comment, and you don't know that people are seeing this, and you're just doing it for whatever. So I'm happy to know that we're making a difference. So I appreciate it. I appreciate all the kind words. We're talking open enrollment mindset, right? Today is October 5th. Actually, my one-year-old, my son, my baby is now 1 year old today. So today is October 5th. We are just on the eve of open enrollment. It's kind of pre-open enrollment, pre-AEP too for you Medicare agents out there already getting into the swing of things, right? I'm seeing some serious activity increase in the Medicare space as well. And so it's the season, you know, quarter four, it's the time to get after it. So we've got to get our mind in the right space, right? So a couple of pieces of advice for you, right? I've got five things technically that I think are going to help you get in the right mindset for open enrollment. The first is take some R&R, right? You've worked hard all year, you know, might be a little bit late. If you still have things, you procrastinate, if you're still, you know, dealing with contracting, if you're still, you know, getting up to speed on training, or, you know, whatever the case is, maybe the R&R isn't for you. Maybe you just need to buckle down and get to it because you procrastinated. But hey, that's your fault, right? Can't blame anybody but yourself. But if you are prepared, or at least feel pretty prepared, you know, take a long weekend. You know, enjoy some time with your family. Matter of fact, while you're enjoying that, this again, side note, while you're enjoying that time with your family, stress the importance of the next 45 days, 60 days for you, and how big it can impact, how big of an impact it can make on your family's financial situation, and exactly the difference that you're going to be able to make, right? So take some time, spend it with your family, spend it with those that you love, because what you're going into, if you're like me, if you're like the other agents out there that are absolutely, you know, going to crush it throughout this open enrollment period, take some time to rest, okay? But after that rest is over with, start, right? Begin now. Start stacking your calendars. One of the pieces of advice that I always give to veteran agents in this time frame is to start to clear your calendar of all those renewals, right? I love renewals. Everybody in insurance loves renewals. But guess what? New business is how you grow. If you write 100 clients, okay, and then you rewrite that same 100 clients year over year over year, first of all, props to you for great persistency. However, your business is actually dying. I don't believe, truthfully, I don't believe that stagnation or staying the same equals any growth. In fact, obviously, it would be impossible to argue that it does. I believe a business that stays the same is actually dying because inflation, because everything else, right? If your business is not growing, it's dying. It can be one or the other. And so clear your calendar of a lot of these renewals, right? Get with the clients you've had for years. Find out if they're planned. And you can do this mid-October. You know, starting mid-October, you can start to preview plans for the 2023 year. Clear your calendar of those renewals. I want you to think of those renewals as a bad thing, right? As if you're spending time, but a lot of time, right? You may have a large book and it's hard to get through all of your renewals pre-OEP, obviously. But if you can get through a big chunk of them, that's space you've cleared on your calendar. Or maybe you hire somebody, right? You hire an LOA to help you with those people. But that's space you've cleared on your calendar to allow for new business, right? New business is going to equal growth. So start now. Clear those calendars of new business. Hey, and on the topic of clearing your calendars, clear your freaking calendars. What I mean by that is you've got a trip planned for this time frame, or you know, you've got, I don't know what it is. Holidays tend to have a lot of this. You know, if you are in a great spot where it doesn't really matter to you, you know, how well you do through open enrollment, I can understand it. But if you're struggling throughout the year, or if you're trying to build a business, this is the time that can really make a difference. So take all of that stuff off of your plate, you know, clear your calendar, reach out to those loved ones, reach out to the people that you need to, you know, get some understanding from and say, listen, I'm not going to be at that Christmas party that's, you know, 3 days long and in Salt Lake City, Utah or whatever. You know what I mean? It's like, that's not a Christmas party. That's a vacation. And I can't take a vacation over the next 45 days because it is crazy. Right? I know that sounds crazy. I know that sounds extreme, but I promise you, man, you make those type of sacrifices, you're going to get a lot in return, right? So clear your calendars of the BS, okay? I'm going to take Thanksgiving off. I'm going to take Christmas off. I'm going to maybe even take a day off before or after that. I may take New Year's Eve half day, right? And I'll post my office hours, right? I mean, we have a lot of days that we are working near or around holidays that I would expect agents to be working too, right? It just makes sense. It is the time to make hay. Sorry if I got on a soapbox there. You probably think I'm crazy. Build a schedule and stick to it. So along the lines of clearing your schedule, right? Or clearing your calendar, build a schedule and stick to it, right? That can allow you, so discipline actually equals freedom, right? Discipline equals freedom. I know that sounds contradictory to some, but those of you that are disciplined, you know exactly what I mean. If you can build a schedule where it does allow for a few days off around the holidays, okay, because you're making up for it in other times, and then you can stick to it, okay, don't do what I'm so guilty of. I'm like the king of this. It's like, you know, it's 8 o'clock in the evening and I'm working and I'm like, you know what? I'll wake up super early and do this tomorrow morning, right? Like, I got this. I'll do this tomorrow morning. Okay, and really, then I wake up and I don't do it tomorrow morning. And it's like, all I did is lied to myself and said, you know, that I built this schedule to make me feel good about myself. Like, these are the hours I'm going to work. But then you don't stick to it. It means absolutely nothing, right? And lying to yourself is the worst type of lie, because then you start to not believe the things you're telling yourself. Like, I can do this.
It's not a lie if you believe it.
No, you can't, you jerk. You can't even freaking wake up early to finish your task. I deal with that on my own, right? I know that you struggle with it too. Everybody does to some degree. The degree that I struggle with it may not be like most times I'm going to do what I say I'm going to do, but a lot of times, certain times, you know, you're saying something just to justify in your own head. So build a schedule, but more importantly, stick to that schedule, because the discipline in that is going to equal freedom. Okay, freedom financially, freedom of your time, freedom because you're getting the things done when you need to get them done so that you can take time off when you need to take time off. And then lastly, focus on productivity. I spelled it wrong, but business, busyness. Focus on productivity over busyness. I'm guilty of this myself, right? A lot of times I see Eric smiling behind the camera. A lot of times I'm smiling to myself because I'm over here like harping on something that I struggle with. That's the way that we try to, this way that I try to, you know, train is like, hey, listen, I've been there. I know how it feels. I'm going through it now. Whatever it is, I'm speaking from those topics, not shit I don't know anything about, right? Focus on productivity versus busyness, right? Make sure that the things you're doing freaking matter, right? I can tell you that honestly, this has been one of the biggest lessons over the past let's call it 3 months, where I've started this new project that I've been working on, and it's been a big undertaking. And I truly feel, for the first time in my career, that I've officially taken on more than I can handle by myself. And it's almost a freeing feeling, because it's like, okay, I've reached the point in which I feel like I've maxed out my product. I couldn't get more done in a day if I tried. So boom, I've got to start handing things. It forces me into a position to start handing things off, to start being more productive with my time than busy. I look back at the times where I felt like I was busy before, and I'm like, holy shit, I wasn't busy at all then. Like, man, I was busy. I wasn't productive. Makes sense. So focus on productivity over busyness. If you find yourself doing, you know, mediocre tasks, non-money-making activities during the season of open enrollment, right? You're keeping yourself busy, but you're not being productive. So get in the right mindset. Start now. Clear those schedules so that you can build out a schedule that you're going to stick to and focus on productivity versus just being busy doing nothing. Hope that helps, guys. Drop a comment. Let me know how you stay productive, how you stay focused, and how you get in the right mindset for open enrollment. And lastly, if you're not following or you're not subscribed, whatever the hell you call it, subscribe to the channel. Subscribers are growing. Comments are growing. Everything's growing. We so appreciate it. Crush open enrollment. I'm a health insurance hustler. Bradley Hannon's the name. I'm here to teach these agents how to play the game. I'm a health insurance hustler. One thing you should know about me. I'm a health insurance hustler. Brad Hannon.com.